So, the other thing we did on the intermediate lesson today was just going over active to passive or passive to active. Now, we use an active sentence to show that something or somebody did something. So, the hurricane has hit the Caribbean. This guy, Charles Watkins, has escaped from prison. Or, I have given this guy over there a pen. Now, if I want to make them passive, I want to talk about the object. So the Caribbean has been hit by a hurricane. This prison has been escaped from. I hate that sentence, but it works. A pen has been given to him, okay? Sometimes we want to show who did the action at the end, but we don't have to, and that's the beauty of passive. We want to show what happened to the object. In this case, the Caribbean. In this case, a prison. In this case, a pen. Over here, we started with passive sentences. Two Spanish novelists have been given a Nobel Prize by a judge. But then we decided we're going to make it active again to show what the judge did. A judge has given the prize to the novelists. Here, 2,000 people have been fired by the managers. And we wanted to show what they did, so we made this active. The managers have fired. So look at what we're doing here when we change a sentence. Look at the language we have to use. An active sentence has, in the present perfect, subject, auxiliary verb have or has, and the past participle, an object. The passive is where we move the object to the subject. We leave the auxiliary verb, but we add the verb to be, also in the past participle, and then we ensure that the main verb is in the past participle. And with present perfect, it already is, so we don't need to do much to make an active sentence passive. Learn these and do the units in English grammar in use. Units 42, 43, and 44. Get up to speed with passive in all of the tenses, because we're going to be working with this language for the next few weeks. Thanks.